Hello everyone in Medical Scribe. I'm Karar Haider, a doctor graduated from Baghdad Medical College. We knew from the previous videos that the bone tissue of two types, compact bone and spongy bone. And we say that the compact bone will form the superficial hard layer of the bone. And to inside of it, there will be a bony mass, which is the second type of bone tissue, the spongy bone. And today, our talking would be about this type. The spongy bone, which is also called the trabecular or the cancellous bone, is defined as a light, low density, and weak bone in comparison with the compact bone. These features will make this type more flexible than the compact bone. And as we said in the previous video, the compact bone will count for 8% of the bone mass. So this type will make the remaining 20% of the total bone mass in an adult human. Well, where this type found? This type will be found mainly in the end of long bones, near the joints, and inside the vertebrae. And although the spongy bone structurally consists of osteocytes inside lacunae, as in the compact bone, the structure arrangement here differs from the first type, in that there are no osteans here. What it presents is an interconnecting bony plates and rods, which called the trabeculae. So the osteocytes will be within these trabeculae. Now, if someone looks at these trabeculae, it seems randomly arranged. But in fact, the trabeculae are arranged in an optimal and efficient manner to bear the mechanical stresses and strains, exactly like the braces that support the building. And between this complex network of overlapping and interconnecting trabeculae, we will find spaces or cavities that is often filled with bone marrow or blood vessels. Alright, now if we want to know how these cells get its nourishment, we have to understand some details firstly. We said that the osteocytes will be located in the lacunae, right? And these lacunae have canaliculi, which are channels that move and interconnect with the adjacent cavities, right? So the cells can get its nourishment from the vessels inside those cavities through the canaliculi, which in fact act as the Haversian canal of the compact bone. Lastly, in today's video, we will know the functions of this type. Firstly, it will provide structural support and give a flexibility to the bone. Secondly, as we know, the weight of this spongy bone is relatively less than of the compact bone. This will reduce the total weight of the bone, so the muscles can move the bone easier. And the last thing is that the red bone marrow inside its cavities will be the factory that produces blood cells, such as white blood cells, red blood cells, and platelets. And that's it. I hope what I said makes sense. See you next video, and goodbye.